children, welcome back to the channel. This lesson is all about nouns. In this lesson, we will discuss types of nouns that are in English. First, we'll discuss about concrete nouns and abstract nouns. And then we'll look at common nouns and proper nouns, which are very important. And then we'll discuss a very interesting collective nouns. And finally, we'll turn to the countable nouns and uncountable nouns, which are very important related to the nouns. Let's start with what is noun. Noun is the name of a person, animal, place, thing, feeling, idea. So noun is nothing but what? Naming words. What is the name of this object? Pencil, right? Pencil is the naming word for this object. For example, girl, name of a person. Dog, name of a animal. Park, name of a place. Bag, name of a thing. Okay, let's see this example sentence. Ram likes to go to the zoo and see the animals. Here three nouns are there. Can you find out? Ram, zoo, animals. Okay, let's see what is concrete noun. Concrete noun. Concrete nouns are the nouns that have physical existence. That means we can see them and touch them. Here, comb, pencil, chair are the examples for concrete nouns. Because these are physically existing objects, means we can see them and touch them. Let's see abstract nouns. Abstract noun. Abstract nouns are the nouns that don't have physical existence. That means we cannot see them and touch them. And these are ideas and feelings. For example, love, happy, sad, anger. All these are abstract nouns because we cannot see them and touch them. They are just feelings, right? Let's see this example. Honesty is the best policy. Here, honesty is abstract noun and policy is also abstract noun. Let's do practice with some examples. Underline the nouns and say what type of noun it is. First one, my grandmother is full of wisdom. Nouns are there, grandmother and wisdom. Grandmother is concrete noun and wisdom is abstract noun because we cannot see and touch wisdom, right? So wisdom is abstract noun. Second one, the dove is a symbol of peace. Here, dove is a concrete noun and peace is a abstract noun. Because we cannot see and touch them, right? Next, third one. They laughed at my idea. Idea is an abstract noun. Let's see important topic, common nouns and proper nouns. What are common nouns? Common nouns are general names of people, animals, things or places. And proper nouns are special names of people, animals, things or places. Look at here, he is a boy, he is a boy, he is also a boy, right? So boy is a common name to them, so it is a common noun. Next, proper noun. What is proper noun? Proper noun is a special name. Ram is a special name to him, okay? Faraz is a special name and John is also special name. So proper nouns are special names of a person, animal, things or places. And one more important point is proper nouns are always taught with capital letter, right? Let's see some examples. Here some examples are given for common noun and proper noun. Country is a common noun. India is a proper noun. Month is a common noun. March is a proper noun, means which is a special name, gives identity. And day is a common noun. Sunday is a special name, means proper noun. Next, girl is a common noun. Neha is a proper noun, right? Let's see collective nouns, which is very interesting topic. Collective nouns are nothing but a name is used for a group of people, animals or things. For example, family, team, army, etc. Family is a name given to a group of people, right? See here, group of flowers are there. So we can call it as bunch. Bunch is a collective noun. Here, group of keys are there. We can call it as bunch of keys. So bunch is a collective noun. Here some examples are given. A group of students, class. A group of employees, we can call it as staff. Like this, some examples are given here. Let's see the most important topic related to nouns, countable and uncountable nouns. Countable nouns are words which can be counted. For example, book, pen, building, mango are countable nouns because we can count how many books we have. We can count how many pens we have. So these are all comes under countable nouns. Next, uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are words which cannot be counted. For example, water. We cannot count water, right? Air, salt, love. All are uncountable nouns. Look at here. Here I kept salt and sugar. Can you count salt? No, we cannot count them because it contains small crystals. So we cannot count. It is uncountable. So salt is a uncountable noun. Like this, sugar also. We cannot count them. So it is a uncountable noun. Sugar is a uncountable noun. So this is all about nouns. Hope you understand this. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe.